We are in a chapter called arithmetic progression, and we solve bundles and bundles of problems. And I am in exercise 1.3. 14 problems I completed. Now I am in the 15th problem of this particular chapter. Now I am going to complete this chapter, then only I start the next chapter. Another few problems left. I solve those problems and then I go to the next chapter. See ya. Before starting the lesson, it is our duty to recall all the content what we studied in this chapter. The first thing is definition of AP, arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression is a list of numbers in which each term is obtained by adding a fixed number to its preceding term except for the first term. A comma A plus D comma A plus 2D is a general form of arithmetic progression. A is the first term, D is the common difference. To find the common difference, we are using the formula D is equal to AN minus AN minus 1. Or we can use D is equal to A2 minus A1. And then to find the nth term of an arithmetic progression, there is a formula, that is the first formula we are used, that is AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. To find the sum of the arithmetic terms of the arithmetic progression, we are using three formulas. One is SN is equal to N into N plus 1 divided by 2. This is the very peculiar formula we use only to find the sum of the first n natural numbers. Then SN is equal to N by 2 into A plus L. SN is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into D. These two are the formulas we are using depending upon the problem is concerned. In the previous class I told you one more formula, that is the relationship between the term and the sum. AN is equal to SN minus SN minus 1. This one much only formula we are using in this chapter. It is your duty now to write all these formulas in your one formula book and see those formulas. Understand. Once you understand the definition and the formula, then you can try to solve the problems. And I told you that the statement problems are very important in this particular chapter, because this particular chapter is going to fetch you 3 to 4 marks questions. Total there may be 7 to 9 marks is there, but we get a 4 marks question and 3 marks question in this particular chapter. Therefore, statement problems you have to give at most importance. Concentrate on those type of problem. Today we are going to solve majority of the problems are statement problems. See the 15th problem of exercise 1.3. See, it is like this. See, such a big statement it is. Major portion of the board is covered only by writing the question. Right, the question is like this. A contract is there. Some people, they are going to join commerce and first POC. There you will learn the law of contracts. A contract on construction job specifies a penalty for a delay of completion beyond a certain date as follows. Means, see, don't be in the impression in our country it is going to follow. The majority of the country, majority of the bigger construction work, they use this. Always they make a contract. Contract means an agreement between the builder and the person who wanted to construct. Suppose a builder, means a constructor, delays his work. For example, I wanted to construct a house. I give to one contractor. I tell the contractor, you have to complete the work in 1 year. Suppose if he not completed that work in 1 year, that from after that, every day there is a penalty. There is a penalty. There is a fine for him. That's the type of the law is there in our country, but we are not following. Therefore, in our roads and everything, the construction work remains pending for years and years. You have to understand. You are young people, you have to understand contract is there. You can make a contract with a builder or a contractor. After you give a specific time for him. After that, he has to pay fine. He has to pay fine. See here. A contract on a construction job specifies a penalty for the delay of the completion of beyond a certain date as follows. Rupees 200. The fine is like this. If a builder, if a contractor makes 1 day delay, rupees 200 for first day. 1 day delay means 200 rupees you have to pay.
250 rupees for the second day. If one more day means, you have to pay, the next day you have to pay 250. Third day, 300 rupees. Every day, 550, 50, 50, we add that. That much of fine we have to put in that contract. Then only that contractor may complete his work at a specific time. See, the delay is like, the fine is like this, 200 for the first day, 250 for the second day, 300 for the third day, yes, like that. The penalty for each succeeding day, each day being rupees 50 more than the preceding day. 50, 50, 50 rupees we are adding for that. How much money the contractor has to pay as the penalty if he has delayed the work for 30 days? Suppose he has to complete the work in 1 year, he are unable to complete the work in 1 year, he took one more month extra. If he took one more month extra, he has to pay penalty for that. How much penalty for the 30 days we have? Very easy problem it is. See, always see, when the problem looks lot bigger, answer becomes small. Why? Because you have to learn, study this. You have to understand it. To understand also, they give marks, right? Now see, what is that penalty? First we have to make a list. List of numbers. First we make the list of numbers. The list of numbers. The first day penalty is 200 rupees. Second day penalty is 250 rupees. And third day is 300 rupees. Like this, he made a delay of 30 days. 30 terms. We should not write days, 30 terms. See, 200, 250, 300, like this. Common difference is only given. The common difference is 50. Every day 50, 50, 50 again. A is 200. D is 50. N is equal to 30. Simple. Therefore, the answer is very simple in this. Problem may be looking bigger, but the problem and answer is very easy. A, the first day penalty is 200 rupees. D, there is no need to find because he is given that. The preceding day and succeeding day difference is 50 rupees. 50 rupees D. How many days he made the day? 30 days. Therefore, N is equal to 30. And we have to find, yes, 30. Sum of the penalties for 30 days. D is given, N is given, A is given, the formula is, last term is not given, therefore the sum is, the formula is, SM is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 of T. 2A plus N minus 1 of D. Formula. Then what next is? Substitution. Yes, what is the value of N? 30. Yes, 30 is equal to 30 by 2. N is equal to 30, therefore N by 2 is nothing but 30 by 2 into 2A. A value is 200. Bigger number, that's all. Plus N minus 1, 30 minus 1. D is 50. D is 50. Now, simplification. After substitution, we go for simplification. 30 by 2 is 15. 30 by 2 is 2 1s are 2 15s are 15. 2 into 200, 400. There is no difficulty in multiplication, right? 2 into 200 is 400 plus 30 minus 1 is 29 into 50. 29 into 50. First thing is, we have to multiply and then go for the addition. Like the next step is, I write in here, S30 is equal to 15 into 400. Now I am multiplying this 29 into 50. What I do is, I multiply 29 and 5 and then I put a 0. 9 5s are 45. 4. 2 5s are 10 plus 4 is 14. And I left one 0. 0. That is 9 5s are 45. 4. 2 5s are 10 plus 4 is 14.
1450. Now you have to add 400 and 1450. Yes, 30 is equal to 15 into, divide it into only, 400 plus 1450 is 1850. Simple it is. 1850. Now we have to multiply. Yes, 30. We multiply by 15 only because many number of times we use the table of 15. 15 into 0, 0. 10 into 0 is 0. 15 fives are 75. 75 means 5. 7 is 7. 15 eights are 120. 15 eights are 120. 120 plus 7. 127. Then left with what? 12. Left with 12. 15 ones are 15. 15 plus 12. 15 plus 12 is 27. 27. Therefore, the total penalty, the contractor has to pay the penalty if he made the delay of 1 month. He has to pay 27,750 for the person who is constructing the house. Therefore, total penalty is equal to 27,000 rupees. You can write rupees. Rupees 27,750. In this problem, you have to understand this. There is a law like this. If a builder or a contractor makes delay, he has to pay the penalty. It is a nice question, but the answer is very simple. The answering method is very simple. They are using the formula that is SL is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 into B. Substitution and simplification. Problem looks lengthy, but the answer is easy. And this type of problem, I told you, this type of problem, statement problems are very important for the examination. Therefore, what you have to do? Write the classwork once, then transfer to notes, write twice, understand, and solve the problem independently, right? See the 16th problem. It is always a statement problem. You have to read the statement problem properly and understand, then only you can solve the problem. Usually statement problems are easier. But you have to understand the statement problem. See, a sum of rupees 700, sum, they are given, the sum of rupees 700, therefore the sum is given. How much it is? 700 is to be used to give 7 cash prizes. 7. How many prizes to give? 7 prizes. What is the total amount? 700 rupees. To give 7 cash prizes to the students of a school for their overall academic performance. A nice school it is. A school is giving 7 prizes of costing total 700 rupees for overall academic performance. Usually people they give prizes for non-academic performances. Here the school is giving academic performance. A first rank student, second rank student, they are giving prizes. Right? 7 rupees, total sum of 700 rupees is used to give 7 cash prizes for their academic performances. If each prize is rupees 20 less than its preceding prize, means first prize is 100 rupees, let us assume. First prize is 100 rupees means second prize becomes 80, 20 rupees less. 20 rupees less it is, less. The common difference becomes minus 20. 20 less than its preceding price. Find the value of each of the prizes. You have to find the value of each price. See, the problem is very nice it is. These are all practical problems it is. See, in your school also you have to participate in this type of academic performances and to get the prize, right? See here, what is given? Sum is given. S is equal to 700. Total sum is equal to 700. To give how many prizes? 7 prizes. Therefore, N is equal to 7. Therefore, this is S7. Sum of the 7 terms is equal to 700. N is equal to 7. And academic performances. Each price is rupees 20 less than its preceding price. Means common difference d is equal to minus 20. D is equal to minus 20. Here we have to find the value of each price. First we find the value of the first price. First price is first term. First term is A. We have to find A here. A is the first price. Then we have to subtract 20, 20, 20. How many prices you have to make? 7 prices. What is the total cost? 700 rupees. That is the concept for this particular problem. I repeat once again. The total sum of 700 rupees is distributed among 7 students as the price for their academic performances, and each price is rupees 20 from the preceding one, and we have to identify the amount of each price. We don't know the first price. First price amount we don't know. Therefore, first price is first term A. Which is the formula? Tell me. SN is there, N is there, D is there, A is not there. Therefore, we have a formula that is SN is equal to N by 2 into 2A plus N minus 1 of D. Very simple, easy problem. Why I use this formula? D is given, N is not given, last term is not given. And you are writing the formula every day in the assignment. I am giving the two formulas. Formula writing, you get the idea of formula. Last term is not given, D is given, therefore we are using this formula. Yes, 7 means what? Yes, 7, that is 700. What is the value of N? 7 by 2. Now I am substituting the values. 2 into A, we don't know the value of the first price. Therefore, it is 2A only plus N is equal to 7 minus 1, D is minus 20. D is what? Minus 20. Substitution is over. Now go for simplification. 700 equals, we can cancel, if you cancel, you get decimal number. Don't go for the decimal number. Then it becomes 2A plus 7 minus 1 is 6. 6 into minus 20. One stage you have to complete in one step. The next step is identify these two. That's all. 700 is equal to 7 by 2 into 2a. Now it becomes minus. Minus into plus is minus. 6 into 20 is 120. Now see, here 2 is there. To eliminate 2, we have two methods. One is the method of cross multiplication. Another one is, if there is a common factor between these two numbers as 2, take that common factor and eliminate. Which is better? Elimination is better. Why? Because by eliminating, the value of the number becomes lesser. Easy to simplify, right? Therefore, we go for 120 and 2. I can take 2 as a common factor. Therefore, 700 equals 7 by 2 into, should take 2 as a common factor. I take 2. When I take 2, this becomes 8. 2 into 8, 2A minus. This becomes 60 because I have taken 2 as a common factor. 2 into 60, 120. Now, what I can do? I cancel this 2. Then, what is going to happen? 700 is equal to 7 of A minus 16. Here also we have two methods. One is 700 is there equals 7 is there. Therefore I can divide both sides by 7. I can eliminate this number. Or I multiply this number and then transfer. Which is better? Division is better. Why? Because by dividing numbers becomes lesser. Therefore the next step is 700 by 7 and divide by 7 is equal to A minus 60. See, 700 by 7, where is the 7 gone? It is dividing this 700. 700 by 7 is equal to A minus 60. Easy there, 700 by 7 cancel, 100 it becomes. 7 1 0 7 is it 2 zeros is equal to A minus 60. Now what should we do? Minus 60, I transfer to this side. 100 plus 60 is equal to A. Therefore, A is equal to 160. First price is 160 rupees. First price is 160 rupees. And every price is 20 rupees less. Therefore, price amount will be 160 is the first price. First price is, how many prices are there? 7 prices are there. First price is 160, second price is 140, third price is 120, fourth one is 100, fifth one is 80, and sixth one is 60, last price is 40. 20, yes. 160, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 prices. See, this problem is having a verification also. If you add all these numbers, you have to get 700 only. Because the total amount is kept as 700. We check. This is 300 plus 420. 420 plus 80 is 500. 500 plus 100 is 600. 60 plus 40 is 100. 600 plus 100 is 700. Total is 700. Therefore, our answer is right. The price, first price amount is 160, last price amount is 740. Totally there are 7 prices are there. The problem may look bigger, but the solution is very simple solution. Therefore, statement problems are always very useful problems. Why? Because we can score marks. 17th problem. It looks very lengthy problem. Statement problem. See, in a school, students thought of planting trees in and around the school to reduce air pollution. Nice children, isn't it? Children, they understand. Air pollution is reduced by planting trees. In a school, students thought of planting trees in and around the school to reduce air pollution. It was decided that the number of trees that each section of each class will plant will be the same as the class in which they are studying. See, very big statement to understand. Very simple, he is given an example also. A section of class 1 will plant 1 tree, section of class 2 will plant 2 trees, and so on till class 12. Means, very simple, in a school there are students. There are classes from 1st standard to 12th standard. 1st standard to CBSE it may be. 1st standard to 12th standard. They decided to plant trees around their school. How much they have to plant? 1st standard students have to plant 1 tree. 1st standard. 2nd standard, all students. 1st standard, all students, they come together to plant 1 tree. 2nd standard, 2 trees. 3rd standard, 3 trees. 12th standard, 12 trees. Like that they have to plant. Understood? And one more problem, complication is there. There are 3 sections in each class. Means, 1st standard 3 sections are there. 2nd standard 3 sections are there. 3rd standard 3 sections are there. And 12th standard also 3 sections are there. Each class is having 3 sections. Then, how many trees will be planted by the students? What is the total number of trees planted by the students? We have to calculate. Very simple, very easy. This is thinking, nice. Problem is easy. This problem can be solved by 2 ways. Problem is easy. But you have to think this. See, we start like this. We make a list first. 1st standard, 2nd standard, 3rd standard, 4th standard, up to how many standards? 12th standard. 12 standards. 1st standard has to plant 1 tree. 2 trees, 3 trees, up to 12. How many sections are there? 3 sections. Number of sections is equal to 3. Therefore, we have to write like this. 3 sections are there. 1 plus 1st standard, 2nd standard, 3rd standard, up to 12th standard. Understood? 1st standard 3 sections, 2nd standard 3 sections, 3rd standard 3 sections, 12th standard also 3 sections. We have to find. Now we have to find the sum here.
We have two methods of finding the sum. One is this 3, you are able to understand what is this 3. This 3 stands for number of sections. 3 sections are there of a standard. Understood? If I multiply this, what happens? If I multiply this, it becomes 3 plus 6 plus 9 up to last number. Last number is 36. This is the one. First time I met people, they plant 3 trees because they have 3 sections. And first time has to plant only 1 tree for a section. 3 section 3. Second standard having 3 sections, each section has to plant 2 trees. Therefore, total number of trees planted by the second standard is 6, like that. Right? Now we have to find the sum. Very simple it is. Last term known to us 36. First number known to us. We know how many sections are there. How many sections are there? 12 sections are there. Therefore, A is equal to 3. L is equal to 36. Last term is 36. N is equal to how many classes are there? 12 classes. N is equal to 12. We have to find S at 12. That much only. Yes, 12. Simple problem is. Very simple problem. See, we can easily, L is given. Therefore, we can apply the formula. SL is equal to N by 2 into A plus L. I solve it by 2 different methods. You can adopt any one method. Like this, S12 is equal to N is 12. N is means how many sections are there? How many classes are there? 12 classes are there. 12 by 2 into A is 3. L is 36. L is 36. Now, S12 is equal to 12 by 2 is what? 12 by 2 is 6. Into 3 plus 36 is 39. Therefore, I write it here. Therefore, S12 is equal to, you have to multiply now, 6 and 39. 6 9s are 54. 6 9s are what? 54. 5. 6 3s are, 6 3s are 18. 18 plus 5 is 23. Therefore, total number of trees, total number of trees planted equals 234. This is the answer. Simple, no? See, I repeat it again. There are 12 classes. First standard, second standard, third standard, up to 12. How many sections are there? 3 sections. Therefore, 3 of number of classes. 3 of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. Multiply. First number is 3, last number is 36. First number is A, last number is L, 36. How many numbers are there? 12 numbers are there, that is L. See, we can solve this problem in another method. I tell you, it is that method. I write this second method. Always try to solve problems in various methods. Second method, no, you can try to solve in one more method also. Third method also we can use. Second method is like this. See. Don't get confused. What problem is over? I am writing the second method. I write this one. 3 sections. First standard, second standard, third standard, up to 12th standard. Up to how many standards? 12. See the number inside. When you see the number inside, they are all natural numbers. To find an sum of natural numbers, we have a formula called SN is equal to N into N plus 1 divided by 2. SN is equal to N into N plus divided by 2. That is N plus 1 divided by 2. That formula we can use, same answer we have to get. See how to write, which is equal to 3 into, what is N? N is equal to 12. N into N plus 1, N plus 1 is 13, divided by 2, I write here, see, that is because SN is equal to N into N plus 1 divided by 2, sum of the first and natural numbers 12 natural number from which 12 into 13 divided by 2. 12 into 13, how it came? 12 into 12 plus 1 divided by 2. 12. Now cancellation. 6 it is. Same number we get. 3 into 13 is 39. 3 into 13 is 39. 39 into 6. 39 into 6 will be equal. 39 into 6 is 234. See? Same answer we got in only 3 sets. Here we are using the formula Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 divided by 2. That is the formula we use. Same problem. This problem can also be solved by the other method, which is another method. We use the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus n. We can use even that n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. In that formula also, we can solve this problem. I know it. Okay. This is the second method. Third method, see. Therefore, these problems are very nice problems. Why? Because they are all capable of coming for the public examination. All over Karnataka, more than 8 to 9 lakh children are participating in the SLC examination. One child is having one talent. He can use different methods to solve a single problem. See, the problem is, now I write this, you know this, 3 plus 6 plus 9 up to 36. Here, I know the value of A. A is equal to 3. I know the value of D. D is equal to 3. I know the value of M. M is equal to 12. Now, I use the formula. This is the third method. Then don't get confused. Third method. That is your ability. You have to solve the problem by various methods. By that, we learn maths nicely. Now, I use the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. This formula also I can use. Therefore, you never go wrong in this problem. Any formula you put, right. Only 3 formulas are there. All the 3 formulas we can able to do this particular problem. Yes, it is 12. N is 12. 12 by 2 into 2a, directly I write because it is third problem. 2a means 2 into 3 plus n minus 1 is 12 minus 1 into d means 3. D means what? 3. Yes, 12 is equal to 6 it is. 12 by 2 is 6. This is 6 plus 11 by 12 minus 1 is 11, 11 into 3. 11 into 3. S12 is equal to 6 into 6 plus 33. S12 is equal to 6 into 39, same number. 6 into 39, S12 is equal to 234. If you multiply this, you can. Therefore, this particular problem can be solved in many number of methods. Use any one method and learn a problem. See, this is the beauty of mathematics. A problem can be solved by any method. That is the ability of the mathematics, and mathematics never go wrong, and you have to practice this. The problem is very simple. In a school, there are 12 classes. Each class is having 3 sections. There are to plant trees in such a manner. First standard has to plant 1 tree, 12th standard has to plant 12 trees. 3 sections are there, therefore 3, first standard children, they plant 3 trees, because 3 sections, each section 1 tree. Second standard, they plant 6 trees, because 3 sections are there, second standard is 2 trees, 2 into 3 is 6, like that. We can apply any formula. We know A, we know L, we know M. If I take the common factor, the number which is inside, it is nothing but the sum of natural number, I can use this formula. Since I know the first number, first term, common difference, again, I can use the formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. On all the 3 methods, we get same answer, that is that answer. 234, right? See, 18th problem, again a statement problem, you have to understand this problem properly to get the answer. Question is very easy problem it is. A spiral is made up of successive semicircles. It is a blend of geometry and arithmetic. A spiral is made up of successive semicircles with centers alternatively at A and B. A and B. Starting with center A of radius 0.5 cm, 1 cm, 1.5 means 0.5 cm increasing. 0.5 cm, 1 cm, 1.5 cm, 2 cm, that as shown in the figure. The figure, so you understand the figure. I write the figure. There is no need to understand in detail. Nothing is there in this. See, there are two centers, A and B. You have to understand this. The distance between these two points is 0.5. Then I make a mark of 0.5 here. 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. It is just like a scale. Now I make a spiral. See how my scale. The spiral I made. See? One spiral with B as center. If I make A as center, I can make a semicircle like this. It is a semicircle. Semicircle circle means you have to identify the circumference. Circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. Circumference of a circle, formula of geometry. Again, circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. Semicircle means half of 2 pi r. Half of 2 pi r means pi r. 2 pi r divided by 2 is pi r. Therefore, this length of this semicircle is pi r. R is 0.5. 22 by 7 into 0.5. Then, from A as center, I made one semicircle like this. Then, like this. 0.5 increased. Then from there, 0.5 increased. From there, 0.5 increased. From there, 0.5 increased. Like this. Shifting the center. Like this, if you make semicircles, how many? 13 semicircles if you make. What is the total length of the spiral? You have to identify the length of the spiral. Length, total length. One, each one is a semicircle. This semicircle is pi into 0.5. This semicircle is pi into 1. This semicircle is pi into 1.5. This semicircle is pi into 2. This semicircle is pi into 2.5. Like that. Here it is. How many times? 13 times. Therefore, first we start like this. See. How many semicircles are there? Totally 13 semicircles are there. To make a spiral. Spiral is made up of spiral of 13 semicircles. Semicircles. Spiral of 13 semicircles, because since it is an inclusion of geometry, it is better to write what is this. Then circumference. Circumference of a circle is equal to 2 pi r. Therefore, length of semicircle, length of semicircle is equal to 2 pi r by 2, which is equal to pi r. Which is equal to, r looks smaller, I make it bigger, pi r. This knowledge is one. How many such semicircles are there? 13 semicircles are there. Therefore, the list of numbers, pi, first semicircle, pi r 1 plus pi r 2 plus pi r 3, like this, how many? Plus pi r 13, 13 semicircles are there. Therefore, 13 radii. This is the, and R1, R2, R3 he is given. R1, R2, R3 are given. R1 is 0.5, R2 is 1, R3 is 0, 1.5, like that it is increasing. But when you see like this, what we can do is,
Since every number is multiplied by 5, try to understand, I repeat once again. A spiral is made having a semicircle. Length of the semicircle is given by the formula pi r, because the circumference of the circle is equal to 2 pi r. Don't get confused with the area of the circle. Area of the circle is different from the circumference of the circle. Circumference is that the length, boundary, perimeter of the circle, that is 2 pi r. Area of the circle is equal to pi r square. This is 2 pi r. And length of the semicircle is equal to half of, semi means half. 2 pi r divided by 2 is pi r. How many semicircles are there? 13. All of them having different radius. Therefore, all of them have the length pi is common. Therefore, it is better to take pi as a common. Otherwise, each and every number should be multiplied by 22 by 7. Therefore, what I do is, I eliminate pi. I don't eliminate. I take pi as a common factor. Then it becomes r1 plus r2 plus r3 plus r13. Because pi is removed out. Now we know the values of r1, r2, r3, r4 because 0.5. Therefore, I write it. Pi is equal to, pi of 0.5 plus 1 plus 1.5 plus up to 13 means how much it becomes? 13. You have to understand. I can even write 13 terms also. I can write it as 13. If you don't know what is the value of R13, R13 should be 6.5, half of 13. See, 1 is 0.5, 2 is 1, 3 is 1.5. Like that, if you go, it should be 6.5. If you don't understand this, leave. You write it as 13 terms. How many terms? 13 terms. 13 semicircles. Now we have to find the length. That's all. First term you know, common difference you know, n you know, apply, find the sum of this, then multiply by 22 by 7, you get the answer. Right? Then what you can do is, a is equal, what is the value of a? 0.5. What is the value of d? Because every radius is adding 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. 0.5. What is the value of n? N is equal to 13. Now we have to find the sum and then it is multiplied by 22 by 7 to get the answer. 0.5 plus 1 plus 1.5 up to 13 terms. That much only I write. Then after that I multiply by 13. Right? The SN is equal, the formula is SN is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d, 2a into 1 plus n minus 1 into d. Formula it is, right? Now see, yes, 13 semicircles are there, equals 13 by 2 into 2 into a is 0.5. A is equal to what? 0.5 plus n means 13 minus 1 into 0.5, which is that 0.5, d is also 0.5. Now, yes, 13 is equal to 13 by 2. Now, we have to multiply 2 into 5, 10. After the decimal point, one number is there. Therefore, it is 1.0. Plus 13 minus 1 is 12. 12 into 0.5. 13 minus 1 is 12. 12 into 0.5. Yes, 13 is equal to 13 by 2 into 1. 1.0 is 1. Plus 12 into 5 is 60. After the decimal point 1, it becomes 6.0. Therefore, yes, 13 is equal to 13 by 2 into 1 plus 6 is 7. This is the answer for this number. This number. But total length should be multiplied by what? Pi. Therefore, total length of the spiral is equal to pi into S13. Pi into S13. What is the value of pi? He is given 22 by 7 into S13. We got it as what? S13. We got it as 13 by 2 into 7. 13 by 2 into 7 is nothing but S13. Now cancellation. 7, 7 is gone. 2 1s are 2, 11 are. Now which is equal to, here only I write, which is equal to, you have to multiply by 11. 11 3s are 33. 11 3s are 33, 3. 11 1s are 11 plus 3, 14. 143 centimeter. Because the radius is given in centimeter, therefore the length of the spiral is 143 centimeter. Very simple. This problem can be solved in another way also. Because L13 is there, we can write, instead of 0.5, you can write half plus 1 plus 3 by 2, like that also you can write, you can do it. And if you know, if you write this as 6.5, we can use the formula SL is equal to L by 2 into A plus L also you can apply and do it. Simple problem it is, don't get confused. I repeat this problem once again. See this, what he is telling is, there are two points, the distance is 0.5, by taking the centers there, the semicircles are drawn, the radius of the semicircles are increased by 0.5 centimeter. First one is 0.5 centimeter, next one is 1. 1.5, 2, like that it increased. There are 13 semicircles are there. What is the total length of this spiral? This is called the spiral, not circle, it is spiral. But the total length, if you remove this open this, what is the length of that spiral? That is there, he is asking. For that one, we have a little bit of concept of geometry. So, spiral is having how many semicircles? 13, given in the problem. Circumference of a circle, what is the formula? 2 pi r. If circumference of a circle is 2 pi r, then length of a semicircle is equal to half of the 2 pi r, that is equal to pi r. Therefore, list of numbers becomes pi r 1 plus pi r 2 plus pi r 3. Each one is the formula for a semicircle. How many are there? 13 are there. In every term, there is a pi in the problem. Instead of multiplying each and every term by 22 by 7, once only we can multiply. Therefore, remove that pi. The inside the bracket in red, R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R3. What is that R1? 0.5. What is that R2? The radius of the second spiral, 1. R3 is radius of the third one. How many such spirals are there? 13. 13 are there. Therefore, this is 13 terms. Then, A you know, D you know, L you know. You can find the sum of this part, the term given in the bracket. That is nothing but S13. That I calculated as S13 is equal to 13 by 2 into 7. Now to find the total length of the spiral, it should be multiplied by pi. Why? Because we already take a pi as a common factor. Take the pi as pi into S13. Pi is nothing but 22 by 7. S13 I got it as 13 by 2 into 7. Cancellation. Then multiplication you get 143 centimeters. Total length of the spiral is equal to 143 centimeters.